being a superhero is a trial by fire. Who's gonna protect the world if not people like you?
She-Hulk Attorney at Law subverts the usual superhero expectations from its opening episode. Choosing to forgo another action-heavy adventure in favor of its premise as a 30-minute legal comedy, and for the most part, She-Hulk smashes it out of the park. The obvious standout from She-Hulk is its star, Tatiana Maslany, playing dual roles as Jennifer Walters, cousin of Avenger Bruce Banner, and the titular She-Hulk. Maslany's portrayal is warm and instantly likable, and those feelings grow throughout She-Hulk's 9-episode origin story. Her fourth wall breaks, casually talking to the audience and acting as a conduit connecting fans of the MCU to this world, were constantly hilarious and refreshing. Following a road accident and accidental blood contamination while on a road trip with Bruce, Jen emerges as a 6'7" She-Hulk, seemingly without the Hulk's infamous angry disposition. Instead of following Bruce into a life of heroics and explosive action, Jen decides to resume her life as a lawyer, but her green side is revealed in the courtroom following Jameela Jamil's best Kool-Aid guy impersonation as antagonist Titania. Once outed, Jen is tasked with heading up a new law division, representing superpowered individuals and clients, including former Hulk adversary turned spiritual healer Emil Blonsky. It's this setup that forms the backdrop of the majority of the series, and the premise works well within the format of the show and allows for fresh and interesting cases for Jen to tackle in each episode. In addition to the case of the week, the show provides added depth to Jen as we see her wrestle with familial scrutiny over her work and love life, and her own feelings about being overshadowed by her towering alter ego. Some storylines delve into pretty dark places, including revenge porn, and while handled well for the most part, the brevity of each episode sometimes makes these harder themes feel rushed. The final two episodes in particular have a lot to unpack and resolve within their short runtimes, with the finale having to tie up multiple story elements while also contending with an extended fourth wall break which may prove divisive among fans. Ginger Gonzaga and Joss Segarra are fantastic and endearing as Jen's supportive and loyal friends slash co-workers Nikki and Pug. Elsewhere, Mark Ruffalo and Tim Roth return as Bruce Banner and Emil Blonsky respectively, and turn in strong performances as expected. The MCU's linchpin in Phase 4, Benedict Wong's Wong, turns up in several episodes, effectively tying She-Hulk back to the MCU and answering some long overdue mysteries left over from Shang-Chi, while being effortlessly charming and a joy to watch as always. The introduction of She-Hulk into the MCU has continued the trend of Marvel's format experimentation into its fourth phase and has delivered a 30-minute legal comedy series that, while not always perfect, still delivers some of the most entertaining TV of the year and can easily be considered a smash hit. What did you think of the She-Hulk series? Let us know down in the comments, and while you're there, be sure to like and subscribe to stay up to date with all the great content coming from JHT. For more TV reviews, please check out our review of Netflix's Resident Evil, or if gaming is more your thing, we're sure you're gonna love our feature on Spider-Hec, the best game about lightsaber-wielding arachnids ever made. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time here on JHT.
I think I'm jealous. Is that what I'm feeling?